Good morning, students. Today the topic of our discussion is environmental studies. We will discuss in detail about the scope of environmental studies. Before proceeding further, we would like to introduce the topic environment. The term environment means something around us. The physical and the biological world around us is known as environment. It includes air, water, soil and other living organisms around us. Environment can be natural, it can be man-made. Natural environment includes natural surroundings, natural creation of the nature, whereas a man-made environment includes the environment created by the man itself. Now we will like to discuss about the definition of the environment education. The study of environment is known as environment education. It also includes study of various natural resources and their conservation. Environment education is multidisciplinary in nature. It includes the study of various fields like physics, chemistry, biology, geography, economics, commerce, etc. Because environment is made up of different components, hence its study is also multidisciplinary in nature. It includes the study of the various variety of the living organisms and their conservation. Environmental studies deals with the study of various ecosystems like grassland ecosystem, forest ecosystem, desert ecosystems, aquatic ecosystems and their conservation. Environment education includes the study of various types of pollution, that is air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, noise pollution, their harmful effects and their control measures. It deals with the various social issues like global warming, ozone layer depletion, water crisis and their possible solutions. And ultimately we can say environment education develops concern in every individual to conserve the environment for the sustainability of the environment. Now we will like to discuss about the scope of environmental studies. There is wide scope of environmental studies in different areas. It includes green marketing, green services, eco, green advocacy, biogeography, biotechnology, health services, etc. Let us discuss them one by one. First of all, green marketing. What is green marketing? It refers to the sale and purchase of the green products, eco-friendly products in the market. There is more and more demand of the green products, hence there is a need to develop or there is a need of environmental experts and the environmental managers to manage the eco-friendly products so that we can meet up the growing demands of the consumers. Number two, green advocacy. We are having number of areas or issues related to the air, water, soil and the natural resources. As already National Green Tribunal is doing number of cases or the trials which are badly needed to be addressed, and there is need of emerging field, that is green advocacy. So lawyers are required to handle the various trials related to the natural resources. So this is the upcoming field which can help to sustain the environment. Number three, green journalism. We have to address the various environmental issues even during the lockdown, after the lockdown also. And there is a big role of media and the press which can address these issues in a better way. It can convey to the public in a smarter way. There is a need to address all these issues by the environmental managers or the experts which are needed by the press. That means green journalism is another emerging area where the environmental experts are in great demand. Then number four, health services. Every hospital provides, they want to provide the facility of clean drinking water and hygienic conditions. But all these can be maintained by the environmental managers. Biomedical waste can be managed in a smarter way in every hospital. So it means every hospital needs an environment manager to maintain the hygienic conditions and to maintain the biomedical waste. In this way, we can say a health sector can be improved and there can be prevention of the spread of the diseases for the public issues also. Another area is Pollution Control Board. So environmental experts are needed in the area of the Pollution Control Board, the Central Pollution Control Board, Punjab Pollution Control Board, or the different state pollution control boards to handle the air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, noise pollution. All these areas, they can be addressed very well if environmental experts can be in a position to manage these areas. Next area is research and development. Rapid industrialization is leading to the degradation of the environment, and there is need to develop more research and developmental activities which can save our environment, plus it can run our industry also. So it means we have to develop some technologies which can address these issues in a better way. So there also environmental engineers or the environmental experts are in high demand. Next is weather forecasting. All of you know very well we can predict the weather beforehand because of the remote sensing technology. And this prediction of the weather forecasting beforehand help to address the various disasters like tsunami, earthquake, floods, drought, etc. in a better way. Beforehand prediction can help us to give the forecasting to the public. Warning can be given to the public in a better way, and issues can be addressed. It means environmental experts can play a very good role in addressing the remote sensing conditions or the various disasters. Disaster management can be handled better in this way. Similarly, we are having forestry. There is need to increase the forest cover to address the problem of the climate change or the global warming. Green forest cover can be increased only with the help of environmental people. They know how to increase the forest cover. At present also, we are having green mission is going on in India to increase the forest cover so that CO2 level can be decreased and climate change can be addressed in a better way. Besides this, we are having wide scope of the environmental studies in biotechnology, in biogeography, even computer data services, or the global positioning system, global information systems, economics, they can be done or they can be handled in a smarter way by the environmental experts. So with this, I hope so students, it's clear to you, we are having a wide scope or various career opportunities in the field of environmental studies. Now, importance of the environmental studies. Environmental studies play a very important role in creating awareness among the common public so that we can save the environment. It provides us knowledge about the various natural resources and their conservation. It provides us information to address the various social issues like global warming, water crisis, energy crisis, and their possible solutions. It develops concern in every individual to save the environment. It means environmental studies play a very important role to conserve the biodiversity. It helps to increase the forest cover. It helps to reduce the environmental pollution, noise pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, etc. It means by creating the awareness among the common people and particularly youth, we can save the earth to a great extent.